So Samsung recently launched the Galaxy M21, which our internal testing reveals has a camera almost as good as the Galaxy M31, but it comes with a starting price tag of just ₹13,000, which by the way places it right against the Redmi Note 9 Pro. Hey guys, this is Varun from Guiding Tech, and today I'll be putting the camera of the Galaxy M21 against the Redmi Note 9 Pro to see which phone offers a better camera setup for ₹13,000. Let's get started. Okay, so kicking things off in the daylight department is the shot of a big leaf. Now, the first thing that you can notice right off the bat is the difference in the color profile. The Note 9 Pro captures a warmer image, while the M21, which does saturate things a bit, is leaning more towards a realistic color profile. Also, if you pixel peep into the top corner of the leaf, you'll see that the Note 9 Pro forms a halo around the leaf, while the M21 does a good job of eliminating it. Now, one area where the Note 9 Pro slightly excels is in terms of details. It's quite likely due to oversharpening in the post-processing, but right now, the result looks pretty good. Now moving on to this next close-up shot, and you'll see Samsung doing something that it's known for, which is saturating the image quite a lot. On the other hand, the Note 9 Pro is once again going for a warmer image, and that is something that I noted in my previous camera comparison of the Note 9 Pro with the Note 8 Pro as well. Also, this time around, if you pixel peep into the dead center of the image where the focus was, you'll see that the M21 has actually managed to capture better details. And not only that, zoom out and look at the buildings in the back. Both are good shots, but the M21's slightly better dynamic range allows the building's balconies to be better exposed, while the Note 9 Pro overexposes them. Now, I'm not saying it's a massive difference, and both are great shots, and you can easily select for whichever shot you like. Personally, I think the Note 9 Pro is lagging a slight bit behind the M21, but ever so slightly. But then again, there are more shots to come, so let's keep watching. Now in this next shot, things lean a lot towards the M21. In fact, the M21 beats the Note 9 Pro left, right and center in this shot. Yes, there is a tint of saturation once again, but the image has a much better dynamic range, is more crisper, and if you pixel peep into the center, you'll see that the veins of the leaves are better highlighted on the M21 as well. The Note 9 Pro once again takes a warmer image, forgets about the sky and also ends up adding a weird reddish hue. But wait, if you thought the Redmi Note 9 Pro is already defeated, once again, check the overall length of this video and more importantly, check this next shot. In this shot of a white flower, while Redmi once again goes for a warmer image, Samsung's saturation is off the charts, especially with the greens in the backdrop. Also, the most important aspect of this shot is the details. And if you pixel peep into the main bud, you'll see that the Note 9 Pro does a much better job here. Now I'll admit that at a first glance, when you're zoomed out, the M21's image does look more vibrant, but it is way off from the realistic tones, and for this shot, I would any day side with the result produced by the Redmi Note 9 Pro. Now moving on to the ultrawide sensor, and the differences here are quite easy to pinpoint. Of course, the first thing here is the difference in terms of the color profile. While Samsung's shot is once again slightly saturated, it's much more controlled this time around and almost everything is highlighted better. As for the Note 9 Pro, the colors are warm and if you take a look at the buildings, they are not as well exposed as the Samsung shot. Now, it's not like the Note 9 Pro is all bad. In fact, it has the oversharpening factor in its favor. And if you pixel peep, you'll see that the Note 9 actually captures more details in the image. Now taking a look at another ultrawide shot, and the story once again remains the same. While Samsung does saturate, it is mostly controlled when you have a lot of different color elements coming into the frame. The dynamic range is better and the overall image also looks more appealing to the eye, at least to mine. The Note 9 Pro on the other hand goes for a warmer tone, does not have that good a dynamic range, but where it continues to excel is in terms of overall details and sharpness. Now moving on to full res images, both the phones come equipped with a 48 megapixel shooter. Okay, so we've already established the difference in terms of color profiles, so I'm not gonna waste more time talking about it again. This is a major constant here and pretty much carry forwards in all shots. However, in this first shot of a full 48 megapixel resolution, both the images look equally good from the first glance. That said, once you pixel peep, here's the surprising bit. the M21 actually manages to edge the Note 9 Pro a bit in terms of details, which was weird to me because I was expecting the Note 9 Pro to win this bout, especially with oversharpening being its strong suit. But it is quite weird because regardless of where you zoom into, the M21's oversharpening is apparently better than that of the Note 9 Pro. And that is saying something considering Samsung has managed to beat Redmi in an area where Redmi is supposedly the pioneer of. But to stress on this further, I took another 48 megapixel shot in a different setup and Samsung once again excels here. The details are consistently better on the M21 and yes, it is oversharpened, but the shot definitely looks more crisper. The one thing that is all the more peculiar in this shot is that this time around, the color profiles are quite similar. Both the shots are slightly saturated, as evident by the grass, but they're both equally controlled. This just goes on to show that the software on the Note 9 Pro is quite unstable, while on the M21, it's comparatively better optimized. Now I know that of all things, the details part is something that may come as a big shocker, and trust me guys, this was something that basically shocked me as well. I pretty much expected the Note 9 Pro to have better details considering that oversharpening is its biggest asset, but the M21 does a better job and things are whatever they are. And if you need a bigger proof, we always have a download link to all the full res images, so you can download them, check it out and see how both the images are different from one another. Okay, so moving on to human subjects, both the phones seem to capture an equally good image. The only difference here is that the Note 9 Pro tends to increase the overall contrast here. As such, the blacks are more prominent and the brownish leaves are also darker. However, the color profile is still more closer to reality, while the M21, as always, goes for a more saturated shot. It's not too much, but it is noticeable. Now, turning the portrait mode on brings about a major difference between both the phones. Both of them have a depth sensor on board, but it seems like it's barely functioning here. The edge detection on the M21 is bad, but it's worse on the Note 9 Pro. Zooming into Ashish's shoulder will reveal what I'm talking about. It's just bad, and I don't think I like the edge detection on any of these phones, at least in this shot. Okay, so let's change things up a bit. Moving to this next shot, once again you'll notice that Samsung captures a more saturated image, while the Note 9 Pro goes for a higher contrast image. Also, as highlighted previously, if you pixel peep onto Ashish's face, you'll see that the Note 9 Pro does a better job in terms of details, while the M21 shot looks comparatively smoother. Again, we turn the portrait mode on and the edge detection here is, well, not exactly up to the mark. There are areas in which the Note 9 Pro does a better job, for instance, near the shoulders and the overall shirt, while Samsung does a marginally better job at edging out the hair. Also, notice the leaves in the left side of the frame. Now, since both the subject and the leaves are almost at the same distance from the camera, both the phones have kept it in some sort of focus. Though this is one area where the Note 9 Pro's processing takes a lead, since the bokeh here looks natural while identifying the main subject better. Okay, now moving to rear videos, the first thing that strikes is both the phones capture saturated footages, which was kind of to be expected considering the majority of the greenery in the area. Now, while Samsung's footage looks to be slightly better in terms of colors, the Note 9 Pro's footage is crisper, has no noticeable focusing issues, and is overall more stable as well. Add to this the fact that the Note 9 Pro also features a Pro mode for videos, and the Note 9 Pro is basically the pick for videographers. Now, switching up to the selfies, and both the phones are back to their core strengths, with Samsung exhibiting a slightly saturated but better HDR image, while the Note 9 Pro once again goes for a warm image. But like I said, core strengths, the Note 9 Pro is back with better details, especially once you zoom into the face and go for the beard test. Also, I know it's hardly a significant thing, but I kind of fancy that lens flare on the Note 9 Pro. Yes, there's one on the M21 as well, but I personally do like the Note 9 Pro shot this time around. Now, in this next shot, one thing that I need to point out right off the bat is that this time around, Redmi manages to get the colors right. See Ashish's t-shirt? Yeah, the actual color of that is black. And while the Note 9 Pro gets it right, the M21 turns it blue, probably by taking in account the blue strokes of the text. Also, notice the buildings in the backdrop. The Note 9 Pro actually has them better exposed this time around, with the roofs still visible, while the M21 blows them away. Now, turning on the portrait mode, and my last statement is further established. Not only is the image overall more crisper on the Note 9 Pro, it has much better edge detection as well. I mean, that's something that you can notice from the first glance itself. Zoom into the image and you'll notice that Ashish's shoulder is not that well smoothened. And as for the hair, the edge detection on Samsung seems to be a joke when put against the Note 9 Pro. Now moving to selfie videos, the story pretty much carry forwards. You can see that the Note 9 Pro produces a more crisper footage while also getting the colors more spot on. However, Samsung gets its roots right again and you'll see that the dynamic range is once again better on the M21. Also right now, the footage is with the sun in the backdrop. After you pan the camera around to get the sun on the face, you'll see that Samsung pretty much fixes most of its issues. Yes, there is still a tint of saturation, but the t-shirt color is more accurate now, the skies are shown blue as they should be, and the overall footage looks much better than what it was a couple of seconds ago. As for the Redmi Note 9 Pro, it ends up increasing the overall contrast, which is quite evident by the face structure and the lack of HDR also shows. Now, both the footages are great and both of them change their behavior when exposed to different positions of the sun. That's it, personally, I would still stick with Redmi here since it offers a more consistent video performance as compared to M21, which changes things quite drastically. Now, turning off the lights and moving on to low light photography, in the normal mode, you'll notice that both the cameras pretty much struggle. Despite having instances of artificial light at different portions of the image, the shots aren't that well illuminated and there is a lot of noise in both the images. Turning on the night mode, and the first thing that you'll see is that Samsung actually zooms into the image, or actually crops in, which is something that you'll notice on the EXIF data. Now, I'm not quite sure what is the reason behind this behavior, but it is what it is and you kind of have to accept it. Anyway, the talking point is whether the photo is better or not, and well, it does manage to illuminate things a bit better, jumping from 800 ISO to 2000 ISO. As for the Note 9 Pro, the EXIF data reports over 18,000, which looks like a buffed up figure cause the end result is nowhere near to what you would expect. Now, since I have mentioned ISOs, here's one thing, or actually two things, that I need to clarify. First of all, these are smartphones, so obviously the ISO ratings is not something that you can completely trust. Secondly, this is the night mode that we're talking about, so obviously processing is something that is extensively being practiced here. So yeah, ISOs are great and EXIF data is something that you can consider, but something that you should not mark as the end result. Anyway, moving on to this next shot of the market, you'll see there was ample light coming in from the main sweet shop to help with the overall illumination. Now, both the shots look equally good and it's quite hard to pick a winner in this. That is, unless you zoom into the main sign holdings. The M21 does a better job of managing the display lights, allowing the text to be readable. While that in itself is no big deal, what makes it worth highlighting is the fact that it does it without making the rest of the image darker. The Note 9 Pro struggles with the text holding and that shows. Now, turning the night mode on, you'll notice that once again the Note 9 Pro warms up the image a lot, while the M21 goes for a more natural tone. However, the biggest point of notice for me here is that if you look at the shutters above the main holdings, you can actually see the texture on the M21's shot, while the Note 9 Pro completely smoothens it out. Now, I'll be honest, the cropping in factor is kind of annoying, but if you can live with that, the M21 definitely captures better low light images than the Note 9 Pro. And it's not just low light, you know. So throughout this comparison, you'll see that even though the M21 does saturate the images a bit, it does manage to capture images with much better post-processing, have a better dynamic range, and in dedicated camera modes like the 48 megapixel mode and the night mode, the images captured are overall more sharper than what the Note 9 Pro does. That said, where the Note 9 Pro excels is that apart from the dedicated modes, the overall sharpening and the crispness is much better. Another area where the Note 9 Pro excels is in terms of videos. I mean, for videographers, the Note 9 Pro is easily the best option out there, and that is saying something. And that pretty much sums this whole thing up. If you want a phone primarily for shooting selfies or videos, the Note 9 Pro is the better option. That's it for everything else, the M21 seems to be a clear winner. And that is something that I would personally slide with. So yeah, personally, if I had to choose a phone from these two, for the camera, I would pick the M21. Now, there's a stress on the word camera because the camera of the M21 is better. I'm not saying that M21 is a better phone than the Note 9 Pro. It might be. To find the answer to that, make sure to check out GT Hindi, where Ashish will be doing a thorough comparison of both the phones so you can make a better informed decision. And with that, we come to an end of this video. Now, as I've said before, you can always download all the images in full resolution and compare the images for yourself, analyze them, and feel free to leave your critical criticisms in the comments below. Till then, this is Varun from Guiding Tech, and I'll see you in the next one.